in the earth, nothing compared to the road carved ahead. Before you, this is the edge of the divide. Ahead lies your work, the history you burned in the earth, what you brought to the people here. You delivered a package, had markings that matched those in the divide. Not all, but enough. Military markings from some place the bear had savaged in the west. Maybe seeing those markings on it reminded you of home, made you carry it. It was a device, a detonator, one I'd never seen before. Or heard before. You carried that thing to the divide. I know because I followed you as you walked the road, watched you do it. You brought it here, to the community you built, and you are responsible for what happened after, when the device opened, started to speak. When it did, the divide answered back. Those missiles you've seen, buried in their silos. They exploded beneath the ground, cracked the landscape. Sand, ash, the dead. The divide skies became a graveyard. Should've died there, but now that I know you live, the machines here saved me. I was the only survivor, or thought I was. Your package, the message inside, awoke medical machines, close to the one that shadows you, began to build themselves, then others. They only take what parts they find in the divide, never roam beyond it. Can't even leave the silos without a human to shadow. Like hounds. Maybe they saw the flag on my jacket, thought I was of America. If so, history saved me. A sign. Machinery. Simple on the outside. Computer parts. Inside, more complicated. Was the only time I'd heard a machine speak in the divide. The only machine with a voice. If you had been there when it happened, if you had seen the divide break, you would know it. You carry death wherever you go. If the Mojave doesn't know it yet, it will. What happened here can happen again. You've already proved it. What you did in Ashton, the silo there. Didn't stop you though. Like carrying the chip to Vegas. Old world death in your hand. Pieces of the old world like that just need someone careless enough to take them where they need to go, to do their killing. Your roads are not done. Haven't walked it full yet. Not nearly enough. The way ahead and below leads to the heart of the divide. And there, you and I, we'll have an ending to things. Already heard you once, long ago, and loud enough for history to hear. Tired of your messages. Still, curiosity drove you this far. Let's see what else it can do. I knew all of you, your name, your road to and from the divide. what that meant for the Legion. We never spoke. Knew you through your actions. Knew you'd walked the West as I'd walked the East. Learned different lessons. And I would never have discovered the divide without you. At the end of the divide, through the trenches and wreckage, that's where you'll find me. My new home, here, amongst dead men. You and that machine. Keep your eyes on the tower that cuts the horizon. You'll find your way. Made it this far. Not much farther to go.
white legs, meant to show respect. Bribe me for Kaiser's favor, echoing mannerisms and words. Showed them tech caches, taught them the workings of chamber and powder. Spoke of Kaiser's pride in those that used such things. Lies. And then they tried to honor me, not the Legion. They brought me before the campfire one night, showed me how they changed themselves, how they wore their hair now. It was like my entire dead tribe in the firelight, teeth grinning red in the dark, eager corpses, blood-covered ghosts. They had taken my braids, the way of the twisted hairs, as if it showed they were like me, of me. While every knot in their braids spoke of raping, violence, and ignorance of what the knots meant, they thought to show respect, defiled it. Lost myself in trying to read the braids they wove. When I remembered, they had put no meaning in it. They had no history of what it meant. They didn't even know the insult in the twists, knots. And Drywells came rushing back. The white legs circled like that. It was like looking at the dead of my tribe, reborn as ghosts, hateful, hungry, bowing to Kaiser. Another history gone, carried by me alone.
Tommy, I've never seen a robot like that before. It might be dangerous.
He's not dangerous. Look, he's hurt. Can we take him home, Dad? Maybe Mom can fix him.
I don't know, son. What if someone comes looking for it?
Please. He looks so lonely. Maybe if Mom fixes him, he can help her out around the garage.
All right, boy. But if he breaks anything, it's coming out of your allowance.
Yay! He'll be just like Ralphie, only this one's not a toy.
Thank you.